Soil Contamination. This course is brought to you by Gilad James Mystery School. Learn more at giladjames.com. Introduction. In the North Temperate and Arctic zones, large amounts of de-icing chemicals are used during the frozen season for winter maintenance of highways, roads, airports and other surface areas. The transport sector, and civil aviation in particular, has become a major industry and is one of the fastest growing sectors of the world economy, Janic, 1999. Following an increased concern for the environment in general, Lutz, E. and Munasinghe, M., 1994, Willems, 1994, Jackson, 2010, EEA, 2009, Pollution from Airports and Roads, EPA, 1995, has received more attention. It is also considered one of the contamination threats to soil according to the proposed EU Soil Framework Directive introduced by the European Commission in 2006, COM, 2006, 232, Tóth et al., 2008. In this lecture we will discuss various processes that need to be considered from the source to the recipient, which could be the groundwater or surface waters, and how these are affected by cold climate, winter frost. The source will be related to road network or runways, but can potentially be both a line source if no collection or surface drainage is in place, or can constitute a point source. In cases where road or runway runoff is collected in retention systems with subsequent infiltration into local soils or released to surface waters such as creeks or rivers, it could potentially be a significant point source. Often there are no legal limitations on total amounts of salt that can be applied on roads and highways, hence there is no control of their release to the environment. Climate change may cause increased fluctuations about the freezing point, which is a condition which increases the use of salts, French et al., 2010. Hence these chemicals may constitute a long-term threat to soils in areas with frozen conditions in winter. The second process is infiltration into frozen, partially frozen or unfrozen soils, depending on state of soil and snowfall in late autumn/early winter. Frozen soils may create impermeable surfaces and highly affect hydrological conditions and in particular boundary conditions for unsaturated flow. Further, the flow and transport in the unsaturated zone is affected by soil physical and bio-geochemical heterogeneities and in cold climate, high temporal variability and degradation potential due to low temperatures during winter and snowmelt. If or when chemicals arrive at the groundwater level, heterogeneous conditions continue to influence the fate of de-icing chemicals, but the general mechanisms that apply have been widely documented elsewhere. In the next sections, these processes and how they can be measured and modeled will be presented, and we suggest how this knowledge can be used in planning of management strategies. The focus of this lecture is on processes near the surface and in the unsaturated zone. In the conclusions, we discuss challenges still unresolved.